My name is Alex Price, 33, and I'm a mechanical design engineer.
My name is Luis Cario. I very recently turned 33. I'm a systems engineer.
Okay, so I'm Guillaume Lacaz. I am 32. I'm a researcher doing applied mathematics.
My name is Kevin Macko. I'm 32 years old. I'm a mechanical engineer.
We've all been friends outside of this project.
We like each other personally, but we also just like tinkering on hardware and software and electronics and kind of pushing the boundaries of what's possible in aerospace.
We were doing this out of, for fun.
What is very exciting is to build something that goes to space.
We got a beer cooler, we got some fishing line.
We bought a balloon, we bought some helium.
We've got two broken cameras and we slapped it together, sent it up, put a spot tracker in it, chased it in the car, and then we picked it up. We did it a few times over, and I guess we got to the point where we're at today.
We tried out a lot of different materials.
Space imaging is very desirable for a number of reasons.
We've done a lot of launches in the past.
I had done some calculations to estimate how high we would get and
how to do satellite communications,
what type of balloon to use, and all the various design parameters to help us constrain the design space and do something that nobody else had ever done before.
And we are facing new challenges. For example, we need a power source through solar panels
so that we can last days on end.
We have kind of little challenges around, like
a mechanism that uses a heating element to cut through a rope that basically cuts the balloon away and allows the payload to fall back to the ground. And so we've probably built at least 5 or 6 prototypes to see what would work the best. And
gathering spectral data from something that's not a satellite
to demonstrate that we are capable of doing it.
But with stuff you can get off the shelf now, you can accomplish a lot more for orders of magnitude less.
Our first balloon, we just wanted to get it up high enough so that the sky would look black. About 60 or 70,000 feet.
So the whole UAV, high altitude arena is certainly a growing one.
On our second flight, we got up to about 80,000 feet. And our third flight was our best one so far, and we got that one up over 100,000 feet. And at that altitude, there's the atmospheric pressure is about 1%. It's similar to the air pressure on Mars. On that flight, it took about 2 hours for the balloon to get up there, and it took about a half hour for the capsule to come back down. When it first cuts loose, it's going 200 or 300 miles an hour without any jets or rockets, and it hit the ground at about 15 miles an hour, so as the air got thicker, it slowed down a lot. We wanted to make something that wouldn't hurt anybody when it came back.
For this particular run, we're going to take some sweet pictures.
It's a whole lot cheaper to launch a balloon than a satellite. So much so that you could launch hundreds of balloons for the cost of launching one satellite.
And this project it's not a satellite, it's still kind of something that's close to outer space and something that we can work on our own without working for a company.
I think we've been working together on this project for 5 years now. So we have a similar concept of what motivates us to keep doing this, perhaps.
I've always wanted to contribute meaningfully, independently, and in an original creative capacity towards world betterment.
I think when I was a kid, I was really interested in making airplanes.
When I was 5, I started to draw rockets on paper, and very soon after I was like, okay, I want to be able to build rockets.
This is a prototype specifically to test all of our new technologies. Then we'll get the capsule back, hopefully, and then with a different type of balloon, later one that doesn't pop on its own, we will hopefully be able to fly for days or weeks.
And being able to not just having the dream, but also living the dream.
We need more experts in engineering and math and science to advance our country and humanity towards the future.
So that's the goal, and that's what we're working on right now.